Ridge. I'm Mary.
And I'm Caleb. Welcome back to Ridgeline.
This week, for announcements, we have the student body candidate speeches.
Yes! I'm excited. Let's roll with our candidates' videos now.
Hey guys, I'm Riley Jones. First off, thank you so much for allowing me to be your junior class president this past year. Even though the end of this year was not what anyone was expecting, I hope we can reminisce on the amazing memories that we do have. This is a really good year for school spirit, and that's thanks to you guys. Next year, my main goal is going to be to continue the school spirit and to make everyone proud to be a Bear. To this year's seniors, you all are so strong and we're going to continue to support you through this. To my class and everyone else, I'm so excited for next year. I know we can make it the best one yet, and go Bears.
What's up, Palmer Ridge? It's Kyla Dale, and I'm running for your student body vice president. I have some amazing ideas that will make next year the best one yet. I want to improve Palmer Ridge in aspects such as mental health advocacy, community outreach, prom events, make-a-wish events, homecoming events, and especially school spirit. I want next year to be all about you. I want to make sure your high school experience is an unforgettable one. I also want you guys to know that I'm thinking of each and every one of you during this time, and I cannot imagine what you're going through, but I can imagine how it will affect the way we live our lives to the fullest extent in this next school year. It would be an honor to represent you guys, every single one of you. So please vote Kyla Dill as your student body vice president, and I promise to make next year one you'll never forget.
Hey Bears! If you don't know me, my name is Anthony Marcico, and I'm running to be your student body vice president. I chose to run for this position because my skill set is best suited to fulfilling this role. Along with living up to the responsibilities of this position, I also have many visions I'd want to achieve. My main one being the fostering and development of all of your guys' ideas and using them in our event planning. I'll do everything in my power to use your creativity in order to help keep your events as yours. All this is to say that you should vote for me to be your student body vice president.
Hey Bears, my name is Tucker Tuizzi and I'm running for your student body vice president. Everything we do in student council is for you guys, so it's only fair that you have a say in what we do. As student body vice president, I can assure you that I will address every one of your suggestions to the rest of the student council and the school administration to make them happen. With your advice, we can make your next year of high school a great experience, and I hope you stay safe while we are in quarantine. And vote Tucker for your student body vice president.
Wow, that's exciting. Those vice president nominees are really pulling out all the stops. Between slushies, quarantine, and memes, I can't wait to see who will win.
Yeah, same. But it's not going to matter much to us seniors, because we're going to college!
Woo!
Yeah! Oof, maybe. I don't know. We'll find out.
Anyways, let's get on with our show. Well, if you're still bored after our other stuff to do projects, Sam made one more, but took a different approach.
Hey, what's good, Palmer Ridge? If you're like me, you're overcoming crippling boredom right now. Luckily, I have the solution. After extensive research, I figured out the best ways to solve them. So here's three things to figure out your boredom problems.
From movies to music, with the power of the internet, there are plenty of things to do. Here, I'm listening to Beethoven, while next, I listen to Skechers. As you can see, music can evoke powerful emotion to all of us. Next, I watch some new and exciting action movies. Last but not least, here's a book that helps you overcome your fear of monsters.
And a big scary face!
I'm really concerned for Sam in like every way possible. He spends hours in our basement watching weird movies and crying to weird music.
Thanks, Elena. From Ridgeline, I'm Sam Fettis.
Thanks, Sam. Your reactions help my boredom for now.
Next, Kyle, our very own, went into the woods and showed us some hiking safety tips.
While we are encouraged to stay at home, hitting the trail for a hike is a great way to exercise and to get some fresh air, but you need to remember to stay safe. First, follow the rules of the trail, just like the rules of the road. Stay on the trail. It's there for a reason.
The trail actually continues along this way. This is not part of the trail. All these trees and branches and debris that's been thrown across it is there on purpose. This is actually a washout from a recent rainstorm. Don't go down here. This isn't safe. Make sure you stay on the actual trail.
You should never cut across a switchback. Even though you may save a few steps, you are contributing to erosion. Watch out for roots and rocks that are in the trail. You wouldn't want to break an ankle this far from help. Make sure to stay on solid ground. With the coronavirus going around, make sure to stay safe in this respect too, and practice safe social distancing.
I make sure to pull off onto the side of the trail where I see other people to maintain the proper social distancing.
At the trailhead, you can usually find trash cans and toilets. Use them. Don't leave your waste in nature.
The next time you go out hiking, remember your three T's: trails, trash, and trees. Trails, stay on them. Trash, make sure you throw it away at home. And trees, don't pee on trees. For Ridgeline, this is Kyle Ketchell.
Well, thank you, Kyle. I will try and remembering those three safety T's.
Well, it's been kind of cloudy lately. How's this week's weather looking, Jaden?
Hey, PR. Hope you're all doing all right. Although we can't go outside that much, it's still pretty beautiful out. Let's see what the rest of the country's doing. On the satellite, we can see that the East Coast is getting hit pretty bad, with some storms, especially in the New England area. And on the West Coast, you can see some storms that are going to come in off the Pacific. Our area shouldn't receive too many storms this week. Now let's move on to the 5-day. The week's going to be in the 60s during the day and the upper 30s at night. Most of the day will be mostly sunny, so get out and get some sunshine. Well, that's about it from me. Remember, stay safe. And it is Colorado, where the weather changes every 5 minutes. Back to you guys.
Aw, thanks, Jaden. I can't wait for the summer weather.
Yeah, I'm hyped for it to be warm.
Definitely. Well, thank you guys for tuning in. That's the end of our show. It's been a pleasure, as always.
Yep. Have a great week, and don't forget to vote for your student body officers. Bye!
Bye, guys!